be 100% real, y'all. I don't want y'all holding back nothing.
Here on 2K Sports. Friday Hoops Fest coming up next. It's the San Antonio Spurs going up against the Miami Heat. And now time for Kevin Harlan. We'll get you out to the opening tip-off in Miami.
National anthem and a crowd anxiously awaiting the tip-off. Hello and thanks for joining us, 2K Sports fans, for another exciting presentation of NBA basketball with Steve Kerr and Clark Kellogg. This is Kevin Harlan. We've got a chance now for our starting lineups from point guard to center. This game should be a good one. First for the Spurs, Parker and Danny Green are your one and your two, and in the middle, out of Brazil, taken with a 28th pick back in 2008, the 6'11 pivot man, Tiago Splitter. Then there's Kawhi Leonard, and it's Duncan in at the four slot. And for the Heat, Norris Cole and Dwayne Wade combine a guard, and the big fella inside out of Ohio State, Greg Oden. And it's LeBron James, and it's Bosh in at the four slot.
The Heat have magnificent talent, but even coming off an NBA title, they had never put their name into the conversation of the great team until last spring when they went on that amazing 27-game winning streak.
And for the Heat, they were staring right at the 72 Lakers win record, and I'm sure everyone remembers, but ultimately they would fall, Steve, to the Bulls after 27 consecutive wins.
Yeah, that streak to me was one of the great feats in NBA history, winning 27 games in a row in the regular season. So difficult, but it showed you what the Heat were made of. They really were battling every night, and I thought that put them on a great run heading into the playoffs. You know, if you just look at the numbers without knowing who Dwayne Wade was, you think he's probably 6'7 or 6'8. But the way he blocks shots and rebounds, even at 6'4, he just plays much bigger than he really is.
That free throw, no good. And you go back, Clark, to that big man game for Wade, averaging about a block shot a game for his career.
Well, you think about it, he's 6'5, but he actually has a 6'11 wingspan, and you're not going to find a stronger guy at the shooting guard position. He's over 220 pounds, and there's nothing extra there, so he brings a lot to the table.
Now here's Parker. Kicks to Splitter. Out of bounds. Miami takes possession.
Well, that's inexcusable to throw a pass that far off the mark.
Now Wade. He feeds it to Cole. That's good. Cole's got his first 3 points of the game.
That's like a layup for him. He's just wide open out there.
Right now we're going to go to Doris Burke, who spoke with head coach Eric Spoelstra. What'd you find out, Doris?
With the amount of titles and rings the Spurs have racked up in their careers, coach admitted it could be a little intimidating playing against them. He said Duncan is an instant Hall of Fame guy, and that can scare teams. We have to be fearless and play just like they are any other team, any other extremely talented team. Easier said than done, guys.
Thanks, Doris. And out of bounds as the Spurs gain possession. And just over a minute played here in the start of the game. Green kicks to Parker. No good. And the Heat going the other way now. In transition, here comes Miami. And LeBron James gets it to go. LeBron's got his first points of the game.
Tell you what, LeBron can absolutely soar in for the finish. I remember last year, the alley-oop in the conference finals against Indiana just almost put his head on the rim.
Air Freight is a nickname we can dub LeBron James. I mean, he's an unstoppable force and an immovable object. Defensively, the strength, length, mobility. He can wall you up and lock you down and put you away.
Here in the first quarter with about 2 minutes gone by.
Well, I tell you what, Greg Popovich, a really impressive leader for the Spurs. He's able to keep all of his players locked in with what's best for the team. Has a military background, played basketball and studied at the Air Force Academy before serving 5 years in the Air Force. And you know some of the leadership that he brings to his position was learned from his past experiences.
The Spurs have gone 2 or 3 here to start out the game. Parker dishes to Duncan. Leads him in there. And counting, the shot is good. He'll go to the free throw line.
Outstanding job there to absorb the contact and guide it in.
That's how you impose your will against the defender. He came to play.
Hey, Clark, you mentioned Pop's time at the Air Force Academy. That's where he got his start in the coaching ranks.
Yeah, 6 years as an assistant there. He's head coach at Pomona, an assistant coach with the Golden State Warriors and the Spurs, and eventually moved into the front office in San Antonio. But, wow, what an amazing run it's been for him. 17 years as the head coach of the Spurs.
Here's Cole. Deflects the pass. Parker with the steal. And now in transition is Parker. Here we go. The Heat with the lead. It's LeBron with the drive. And the officials whistle a foul on the shot. The bucket's good. He'll go to the line.
Guys, you go back to the short season a year before last, and the Spurs were the best team on the road. But last year, they weren't nearly as dominant on the road. Still solid when leaving San Antonio, but far from the level they played at a couple of seasons ago.
Free throw good, LeBron. And for the Spurs on the road last season, they would still win 23 games in hostile territory. And while that is more than the 22, Steve, they won in the shortened season, they also lost a fair amount more as well.
Well, for the Spurs, Kevin, I think they did what they needed to do. You know, the Spurs manage the regular season. They know when to turn it on and when they can maybe relax a little bit. But the big thing is they just want to stay near 500 on the road, protect their home court, and be healthy going into the playoffs. And that puts them in a good position.
Now, here's Wade. Back to Bosch. Duncan on him. A baseline J. And good. As it just comes right down through the net.
5 of 5 to start the game, and it might be the second quarter before they miss the way they're knocking these shots down. Boy, everything's pure.
Parker, right side. Duncan feeds it to Leonard. Spurs passing it around. 6 to shoot. Parker's shot is off.
Wade seems to be slowing down just a touch. And the difficulty as you get older is you're not a great jump shooter, which Wade is not. So the defenses will back off, and that's the big challenge now for Dwayne Wade, adjusting to that newer style of defense that he's going to be working on.
And Steve, you go back to the strong output for Dwayne Wade last season for the fourth time. In his career, he averaged over 20 points and 5 rebounds and 5 assists a game. Clark, one of only 4 players in the league last season to hit that mark.
And Kevin, he led all shooting guards in player efficiency rating for the 5th consecutive season. Some might argue, but the numbers speak truth. He's the best shooting guard in the game. You know, that mid-range jump shot is not his strong suit, even when he gets a good look like that.
Oden, a screen on Green. In to Greg Oden. Yes, and it's LeBron picking up the assist. Oden's got his first 2 points of the night.
They got themselves in front with some outstanding shooting right off the bat.
Yep, it's been a clinic at that end of the floor, no question.
Spurs trail by 11. Outside, Green. He kicks to Parker. Drop the pick from Splitter. And that one's good. Parker.
You know, the defense didn't exactly try to fight around that screen, and that's why it turned into the easy basket.
The Heat have gotten off to a tremendous start. 7 of 7 here in the first quarter. Odin, a screen on Parker. Here's Cole.
Hey, my.
Parker on the shot a bit long that time.
Boy, we don't see that too often. No defender on him, and he just clanks the open jumper.
Leonard, the pass to Parker. Duncan with it. Odin picks him up. It's Parker with the drop. Splitter. And foul called as he misses. He'll go to the line and shoot two.
Well, if you're going to learn from someone, you might as well take some lessons from Tim Duncan. That's what Tiago Splitter has done in San Antonio. Really kind of growing up under the tutelage of one of the great players of all time.
First one falls for him. And Splitter taken 28th by the Spurs way back in the 2007 draft. But they had to wait 3 seasons, Clark, for him to come over from Spain. And as Greg Popovich was saying just this past season, he's finally showing what he can do because he's been healthy.
Yeah, agreed, Kevin. And I think it was a wait worth making, yes. Quite honestly. I mean, one of the premier backup centers in the NBA the last 3 seasons. And he earned himself a nice payday with his new contract, too.
Here's Cole.
Kick it out.
LeBron outside. Pass to Cole. The feed now to Wade. 6 on the shot clock. An easy 2 points on the way.
Boy, I tell you what, nice little run here in the corner.
Now the story is points in the paint, Clark. I mean, they're getting point-blank shots every time down.
Dino, he's covered by Bosch. Gets the bucket.
You know, Heat head coach Eric Spoelstra worked his way up from the very bottom in that organization. I mean, he got his start as a video coordinator, and through years of hard work and dedication, has really become an outstanding coach.
And that one's good by LeBron.
And as hot as he's been this quarter, the game plan should be simple. Get him the ball and get out of the way.
Parker kicks to Splitter. And it's good on the assist by Parker. Splitter's got 7 points in the game. And back to Coach Eric Spoelstra, as a guy who got his start as a video coordinator, picking the game apart. Steve, he's very comfortable with the new advanced stat movement, analytics in the NBA.
Yeah, and I've had a chance to speak with him quite a bit. He says that the way they use advanced stats is just as a conversation piece in the coaching room. Their analytics department will bring them various information, and it will force them to ask questions, which is very healthy for a coaching staff to do.
And it's going to be out of bounds. The Spurs will take it. A different look now for San Antonio. Matt Bonner, he's checked in for Splitter. And it's Bellinelli in for Kawhi Leonard. 1:30 left in the first quarter. Parker outside. And that one's good.
You know, size-wise, this is not a great one-on-one matchup for him, but he got that shot to go.
But you wouldn't know it by how he finished. That's a nice hoop there. Well, I think this is one of the more amazing stats in sports when you think about it. No matter the season or the roster, the Spurs just seem to find ways to win 50 games. They've done it 14 straight seasons now, which is off the charts.
Ginobili outside. Back to Parker. That's good. Now just a 3-point Miami lead.
You know, he's not the most flashy point guard out there, and you don't hear his name when people talk about the best point guards in the game, but I think Parker is one of the best in the business when it comes right down to it. He's able to do so many things out there for you and just had a dominant season for the Spurs a year ago.
Steve, Parker's fearlessness going to the hoop is what makes him such a devastating player in crunch time. Often you'll see him go right into a bigger guy, take the contact, and still find a way to finish the play.
Now 8 seconds separating the two clocks. And Clark, as you said, the Spurs last season hitting 50 wins for the 14th consecutive season. By the way, that's an NBA record. Second closest were the Lakers with 12 straight, Steve, from 79 to 91.
Yeah, 58 wins last season for San Antonio. Greg Popovich calls it corporate knowledge, just the consistency that comes with the experience of the group. And they've been together so long, particularly that core, that I think it allows the Spurs to really kind of cruise at times during the regular season.
Behind Beauchamp.
Big bonus for them to end the quarter as he beats the buzzer.
Talk about maximizing every last possession you've got. Right there, it was done.
And they're scoring pretty well as we conclude the first quarter. Heat lead by five. And we'll be back right after this.